The first time we went there, it was so much like Mars. I mean, it was just this vast landscape and you didn't know where to sample, or everything looked the same. It was just miles and miles and miles of soil and then a few glaciers, frozen lakes, and you're the only people there. In 1989, we started doing research in Antarctica, and there's a large part of Antarctica, a large terrestrial ecosystem where we can sample soils. And we are looking at soils kind of like you look at them from if you were going to Mars. Is there any life there? And we did find life. We found all sorts of nematodes, small roundworms. They live in the soil. And so we take a soil sample, just dig up a soil sample, put it in a plastic bag, but we want to bring those back to do research on them here. They're brought here, so pounds and pounds of soil. And we want to keep them at the same temperatures that they might experience in Antarctica. So this is a storage archive, a soil archive of samples that we have taken since 1989 to the present. One of the interesting things about the samples, the frozen samples we've got here, is people will ask me, well, are the nematodes alive? They are not active right now. But they are remarkable in that they can survive. When it starts getting cold, these animals will lose all their water in their body. They'll be like little potato chips. And they will survive until water is added and the temperature that they can become active. So for us, it's just like going into the freezer, getting out your dinner you're gonna have, that you get at a grocery store that's in the freezer there. You bring it back. If you ate it frozen, it wouldn't be very good, it wouldn't be active, but you bring it out and you warm it up slightly. These animals just start to move around rather than being small little potato chips.
And this was the composition experiment.
Okay.
I think it's really important that we keep these soils because over time we've had climate change. So we can compare what were the soils and the animals like then to what we see now.